I'm up.
You like that, huh?
Hey everybody, what the flick? Alonso, Bibbs, Matt, Keanu Reeves is back with something he hasn't had in a while, a movie that critics like.
A good movie.
Boom. It's true.
Jesus. Yes. All right, John Wick is a story about a bad man doing bad things to bad people. Let's watch the trailer.
Daisy.
Jonathan, you got out once. You dip so much as a pinky back into this pond, you may find something reaching out to pull you back in.
It's personal.
Where'd you get that car?
What does it matter?
It's not what you did, son. It's who you did it to.
The nobody?
That nobody. It's John Wick.
You working again?
No, just sorting some stuff out.
Task your crew.
How many?
As many as you have.
Hey, John. I thought I'd let myself in.
People keep asking if I'm back. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm back.
This movie is awesome. I had so much fun with this movie.
Yeah, this movie kicks a lot of ass.
Doesn't it? It's just, it's an unapologetically straightforward, gloriously shot action movie. Like, the action is very cool, doesn't call attention to itself. I don't think I saw a single shot of slow motion in the entire movie. It's just well choreographed, well shot. It's the face shootingest movie I've ever seen in my life. I've never seen this many people shot in the face in one movie before.
Yeah,
I had fun.
There's a couple places where they're doing the like tight handheld cameras fight scenes, which I'm never a big fan of. I've talked about that here before. But I did like this movie. I like that it starts out pretty grim, and it takes a minute to get started. And then when it comes out, what Alfie Allen's character, who we know as Theon Greyjoy, has messed with John Wick, and everyone around him is like, oh no, oh no. It's this whole attitude of like, oh, that's the wrong guy, oh no, that guy, oh no. And his actions live up to that kind of selling. And so I like this a lot. There's a surprising amount of laughs in this.
It's got a sense of humor, and I think it's because the world that they've created in it is very playful. There's lots of details that are fun. There's a hotel for hitmen, and there's like rules, you know, like
next no one kills anyone. For dogs.
Yeah, exactly. But like, you know, there's like a playful element to a lot of the characters. But I love what they did. You know, a character with reputation can be such a gift for an actor. But the movie has to play it right. You know, something like, you know, The Third Man. You hear Harry Lime over and over again. That when he finally shows up in the third damn act, you're like, yeah. Here, you know, there's this bit where it's like, you know, who cares if I shot this guy? It was John Wick, you idiot. You know, right. Like, and everyone's just like, ooh, yeah. And the other thing I like is, you know, it's a cheap shot, the way that they get John Wick into action. His wife dies, she leaves him a dog, so he'll have something to love. And the dog gets killed, and it's brutal.
Yeah.
It's absolutely brutal. This is not a spoiler, it's on the first 15 minutes. But like, every single person is just like, killed his dog?
Right.
Kill his son. Don't kill his dog. The dog is messed up. You can't do that. Like, we don't blame him for wanting to kill you.
It's a puppy. It's a very cute beagle puppy.
The cutest puppy. This is a good year for tough criminals bonding with puppies. The Drop.
Yeah.
This is a movie in which the first part is all Keanu Reeves playing with a puppy.
Right.
The Drop is all Tom Hardy playing with a puppy, trying to protect a puppy from a bad man. That's a good device. I want to see more of it. If we can somehow find a way to edit that into Mad Max Fury Road, I would love that. I'm kidding.
I like this movie.
Makes a good year.
I'm just babbling just now. Checking. But I like this movie a lot. It feels like a Parker novel.
Yeah, it definitely does. It did make me think of Point Blank a lot, right? I mean, this is a, you know, again, this is a character that might be a bad guy. You know, it's almost, you know, he at times I was thinking of Leon from The Professional.
Yeah.
This is a bad man, and he's not nice. And, you know, you don't necessarily get a sense that he really cares about the innocents. I mean, he's not using people as shields, but... You know, he leaves a serious trail of bodies in his wake.
It's ridiculous
to get to one guy.
Yeah.
And it's not that he's, you know, we would see other heroes disable, you know, the guard type characters. He doesn't care. He just shoots them in the head.
Well, there's one guy he knows. There's a cute bit where he's just like, oh, hey, Steve. Yeah, just go. I'm not going to tell
him. Yeah, I mean, there is a little bit of like the professional courtesy happening.
Sure.
That's kind of nice and kind of fun. You know, it's you get the sense that this is a small community of killers, and they kind of all know each other.
Yeah.
But I did like this. I don't know that I loved it as much as you. I think that it does drop the ball in a couple places.
Where does it drop the ball?
I think that the I didn't totally feel like the car and the dog and all of it, like, it was a little too much of a buildup sometimes, I think. Uh-huh. It was a little, I guess partly towards the end. Like, and it's hard to say without spoiling it, but towards the end, there's a scene, the way the movie ends felt a little too neat for me.
Yeah, that's a little tiny.
And that's where it bothered me.
It raises a question that I think, like, if John Wick had asked this question earlier, then we wouldn't have had a movie.
Yeah,
I'll give you that. That's a problem.
I feel like it, you know, there's two different versions of Payback, the Point Blank remake.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And one of those has the neater ending, and one of those has the messier ending. Mm-hmm. And John Wick flirts with doing one of them and pivots and goes in the other direction.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where it bothered me. I thought that it would have been a lot ballsier to go with the messier ending, and it doesn't.
I'll give you that. I think that's fair. I still think a tidy ending isn't the worst thing in the world, especially in a film that's so straightforward as this. This is a story about a man who goes on a mission to do something because of the principle of the thing, and it's just a gunshot. It's just him plowing through the movie to get to the end, and then it ends in a way that I was like, okay, cool, yeah. But you know, I had so much fun. I think the action sequences in this movie are some of the best we've seen in a while. It's just a great way of shooting action without calling too much attention to it. You choreograph it well, you make it entertaining, you make it broad and crazy.
No,
it was great.
Well,
it's so much fun.
I'm
I love
sold.
It.
I totally want to go see this. Numbers, please.
8.5 or 8.
8. I'm giving it a 9. I really liked it a lot.
So that's an 8.5 from us. It is at 93 on the tomato meter, which is...
Damn,
93!
For a Keanu Reeves action movie.
Yeah,
well done.
Who'd have thunk? Anyway.
Well done, Keanu.
Check it out.
Most
thanks, you guys.
Excellent.
Whoa.